So, do you guys remember how the other day I started planning a Funko Pop wall? A wall for the Funko Pops. Like, we've got 100 and something, I can't remember off the top of my head, I've got 100 and something Funko Pops. But the thing is, they're not all displayed like well. We've got someone a wall on like a floating wall thing, which we tend to stand in front of in like most vlogs. So they're the Funko Pops that you see a lot of. But then there's also like a shelving unit. Each like shelf's got, I think it's 24 Funko Pops on. It's 12 in front, then 12 behind those. So obviously you don't see the ones that are stuck behind because they're all hidden. So the idea was to make a whole Funko Pop wall that would display every single one of the Funko Pops that we got. And today's the day that it's gonna happen. I'm just waiting for my dad to come round. Then we're gonna have a coffee. Then we're gonna go buy some wood. Then we're gonna go make it happen. We're gonna build it and it's gonna look great. And you're coming with us. So we've picked up some wood here. We've got 6 or 7, I'm not sure, bits for a cross, going left to right, that the things are gonna stand on. We got some screws here, 50 of those. I had to buy a paintbrush because I had to pay £3 and they only came to £1.50. This is £1.75. So I could pay on card for that. And then we've got like 1, 2, 3 bits of wood that are gonna form the sides and then a brace down the middle, down the back. So we've got everything we need. We're just gonna make it now. By the way, excuse the mess, I've had to move everything. And I mean, look at all that, look at all those pops. So all those pops have got to go on the shelves. Good times. Also, I need to tidy all this. All this will be tidy by this evening, okay? Don't worry, guys, don't judge.
That is 110. And that is... it's a bit of a tight fit, so it's not... it's close. There will be a little bit of difference at the top. But that is... there's something like 5 mils difference between that and the top.
Sounds intense. So, hiccup number one has occurred in that when we had the big side bits measured and cut, they cut them a little bit long. And, well, no, they didn't cut them a little bit long. We gave them the wrong measurement. That's on us. So we've got to recut them just a little bit shorter. Oh, my dad has. So we've got the big bits cut down to size now. My dad's making sure that everything's on the level. So we've figured out where the bottom shelf's going.
Yeah.
We've marked out where the second shelf's going to go. That should fit perfectly. Two Funko Pops sit on top of each other, in theory. So we've figured out two things. One, that it's wider here than it is back there, and two, that it's wider up there than it is down there. These houses are strange. So we've got to measure every single shelf out differently. Even though it's just like by that much that it's off, it's still off a tiny bit. Right. Okay. So we've got some shelves in already, although these are just like an interference bit. We need to take this whole thing out and screw them. We've got the shelves numbered, because as I said, they're not all exactly the same length. And we just got to measure the top shelf up. Okay. Next up, after the coffee break, is figuring out where we're gonna drill so we can attach the shelves. Yes, this makes a lot of sense. It's all in the planning, isn't it?
It is.
Exactly. So where we're at now is, we've screwed all these planks of wood into that bit, so they're all secure. Next, what we've got to do is screw them into this bit for the other side. Doing it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all screwed on and it looks good, but the only issue is it's laid down on its side and we need to turn it around and stand it up against this wall and fit it in perfectly snugly. Dear me.
We did it! I don't even need screws to put it in, but we won't put one in because it'll shrink.
Yeah. Now we need to screw it to the wall. Screwing is the next step. Not that sort of screwing.
That's it.
Ta-da! It was touch and go for a second there. Touch and go. But it fit. It just shows how off these walls are. Like, the front bit at the bottom had plenty of room, but the top bit was really tight, so we had to... It was a whole thing. You saw. Who designed these houses? Anyway, it's in. So we're going to take that as an absolute win. Good job. Shun-ta-ta-dun-ta-dun! There we go! It's all filled up. By the way, this is in no particular order. Me and my dad just wanted to get the pops on there, so we've got all sorts mixed in with different stuff. Like, we've got some Star Wars, we've got some Harry Potter, Stranger Things, some Marvel, Monsters Inc. So yeah, we got bits and pieces everywhere, but this is every single pop. Every single Funko Pop that we own, save for one. Which is the Haunted Mansion Funko Pop. But he's over there on a Haunted Mansion shelf. But yeah, this turned out exactly as I expected it to turn out, and it looks amazing. Although up here looks like supremely naked now, so we're gonna have to figure out something for up there. But all this needs tidying. So that's what I've got to do now. Good times. Let's do this. So we are partially tidy. It looks better. Everything's sort of back where it belongs, all the big things. There's just little things like these little tiny Disney Tsum-Tsums, a clock, some books, bits and pieces. All these need to find a new home. They might end up getting binned or sold. I'm not sure yet. Or charity shopped. They could end up going to a charity shop. Anyway, we need to find a home for those. But now we're just waiting for Lauren to get home so she can take a look at the Funko Pop wall. Let's take a look at it back there. Oh yeah, look at that. That looks great. I hope Lauren likes it too. Let's see her reaction. Hey Lauren, close your eyes. Close your eyes and give me a hand. This way. This way. This is the big reveal for you. No, it's all right. Not going to fall and die. Wait. Stand there. Let's just go around this way to capture the face. Okay, open your eyes.
I daren't.
just do it. Just do the eyes.
Oh my god.
Is that good?
It's huge.
That's what she said.
No, he wants to come and have a look.
No, you're not coming in. Away with you.
I don't know, like, there's loads more there compared to what was there, but it feels bigger and brighter.
What?
I know, I don't know if it's because it's sunk further back, because obviously, like, we had that bookshelf, didn't we, and it came out further than what that comes out.
Yeah.
But it feels bigger and brighter, even though there's more there.
I agree.
I like that you left a gap as well, because I'm still campaigning to have the carpet changed in here, so...
Yeah, that's exactly the reason why I left a gap. And of course Lauren's got to show the cat.
He's not allowed in here, but when he does run in here, there was some cardboard down there and he goes and lays on the cardboard, so I'm just showing him the cardboard corner does not exist anymore.
Just show him.
Look! What's that, baby? Do you want to go smell it?
No, why is this happening?
Because I think that's what he can smell. Because I can smell it.
It's weird. This is rather weird.
What is it?
Okay, that's enough of that.
What is it?
So there you have it, we made the Funko Pop wall shelving unit and it looks awesome. Doesn't it, Lauren?
It does actually, yeah.
Which is right there. The wood cost £25, which is about right, what I thought it would be. Bought some screws for £1.50, like I said. So overall, it came to £26.50. That's like a bargain. That's a really good deal for all the wood, the screws, and everything. Plus, all my dad's labour. That was free. So yeah, thank you to my dad for helping out putting all this together. I know it looked like my dad did a lot of the work, but it's because...
No,
it's because I had to like stop to be able to film stuff. I couldn't like screw stuff in and sand and stuff while filming. Well, I could, but it'd have been like this, which would have been no good. So I did do a lot of work too. You can ask my dad, trust me. Anyway, with that being said, we're going to get gone. So we'll see you guys
next time.